Hey peeps, Smudgeandfrank here. Have you ever had that job that you thought going in, oh my gosh, I have wanted to work here since I was a little kid. I can't wait to work here. And then you do work there, and all those fuzzy feelings just kind of go right out the window? Well, that was my experience working at GameStop. A little over a year and a half ago, I needed just a little bit of extra income, so I decided to start looking for a part-time job. The very first one I thought of was GameStop. Ever since I was little, I have always loved video games. They're one of the few hobbies I still have. And I decided, well, maybe I'll look there. Maybe they have some jobs available. I met the manager of one of the stores nearest me, and we really hit it off. It went great, and she asked if I would like a position at her store. I thought, yes, this is my in. A week later, I was scheduled for an interview. Now, I had only had one other interview before this, and it was for a design firm for an internship I did in college, so this just felt different, and it made me extremely nervous. But I went in, met with the manager and her manager, and they basically asked me three whole questions about games. And then I was given papers and told that I had a job with GameStop. I couldn't believe how easy it was. It was kind of shocking to me, but hey, cool, I got a job. I was really excited going in. The next week, I started my training. The manager really helped me out a lot. I had some pretty cool coworkers. Everything was fine. It was a really small store that they trained me at, so it wasn't like there was any crazy activity, but I started to get the ropes and started learning slowly but surely. My manager let me know that in about a month and a half, she and I would actually be moving to another store, a much larger store in one of the most popular malls in my town. I was really excited for it, and I went home that night and hung out with a friend, and before I knew it, I tore my patellar tendon. If you don't know what that is one of the tendons in your knee. So yeah, good job, me. All I had to do was pivot, and I really messed up my knee, which meant standing for extended periods of time was pretty much impossible. My manager was really understanding though, and to my absolute surprise, she said that she would not fire me, she would let me go through my physical therapy, and she would wait for me. She would not give away my position. I was so grateful, and for about a month and a half, I was in physical therapy. I finally got everything done. My knee was back in order and I went back to work at the new location at the mall. There I was introduced to one of the assistant managers who was a really super cool dude. I'm gonna call him Bob. And then I was also introduced to another girl, a little bit younger than me, still in college, who I'll call Julie. She was an interesting character, but I'll talk about her more later. And last but not least, I was introduced to John. Now, John had been with GameStop for 4 years. That was actually one of the few things I ever knew about him. I always tried to converse with him, really simple conversations, like even, what about that weather today, huh? And he would only give me like two words of a response every single time. So he was just a quiet dude. I didn't think much of it. And we went about our work. Now, let me just tell you, since I had been out for an entire month and a half, and before that, I had only had a week's worth of experience training, I wasn't super fast at my job at the moment. I really tried hard. I worked as hard as possible. I was really great with customers, and that was one of the reasons why my manager wanted me at this store, was because I loved greeting customers, helping them with issues, etc., etc. So I really tried very hard, and there were times when I would have to be behind the counter helping people get their games and do their transactions. Sometimes I would be able to really easily find the game they were looking for, find it on our system. I was getting better slowly but surely, but nothing I did was fast enough for John. Anytime I was over at one of our many drawers trying to find a game, if I was just slightly too slow, he would come over in a big huff, slam open one of the drawers, find the game I was looking for, and just hand it to me without a word. I would always say, thanks for your help, and he would never respond to me. He just always seemed annoyed with me, and I didn't know what to do. I was still learning, and I'd really only had 1 week's worth of experience. So I just kind of took it as, he just was a very harsh critic of some people and went about my business. Now, everything got worse when I made my first true mistake. with an order. A customer had come into the store and he had scheduled a pre-order for a game, but he was canceling that pre-order to put credit on a new pre-order and also do a few other things, I think trading in games. Anyway, it was a very complicated process, especially because he had changed his credit line and decided that he wanted to pay money instead, so we had to refund the credit line. It was just a mess. So I was on this order and I tried as good as I could to really get everything correct. And before I knew it, I had set up the pre-order for the customer. He left. He said he was going to be about the mall and he might come back later. And that was that. Everything was great. It wasn't until a few minutes later that I looked at the computer and found that the transaction had not been completed. John caught eye of this and immediately started to panic. He was flailing his arms saying, "What did you do? How could you have done this? What did you do wrong? Are you serious?" I was just kind of in shock. I was like, "I'm really sorry. I didn't know that I made this mistake. I'll fix it. Don't worry." And he's like, "How are you going to fix it?" I told him, "Well, I'll just call the customer. They said they were going to be in the mall for a little while, so they're probably still around and I can call them back to the store and make the fix." And that's exactly what I did. The customer came back to the store. I apologized umpteenth times, just really, really feeling sorry about the mistake I made. And the customer was totally understanding about it. But John, however, was not. He said to the customer that this was a mistake that has never happened before and that my mistake was outrageous. The customer really wanted him to cool down and said everything was fine and he went about his way. The rest of the day was the most awkward thing I have ever had to go through in my life. I was helping a customer with their order a few minutes later after my mistake and I felt like someone was literally breathing down my neck. You know why? Because they were. John was seriously standing right behind me, so close that when I tried to turn around, I accidentally stepped on his foot. And even the customers were taken aback. They just kept staring over my shoulder at him as he just stood there watching every single move I made. It was just creepy. I really didn't feel comfortable. When I told the manager about it later, she told me, "Oh yeah, we've had this complaint about him a few times." I asked her, "How many times?" And she said, 5. I was kind of shocked. I asked her, "Okay, so why is he still here if he's had so many complaints about being too close and making people feel uncomfortable?" And her response was, "Well, he's a great worker, and you are too. We don't want to lose either of you." I wasn't really cool with this. It just seemed like she was making excuses for someone just being way too comfortable getting in people's spaces and making them feel inferior. And that wasn't the only time that that had happened. The next few weeks I was working there, he was just right on my butt. I couldn't go anywhere without him being right behind me. Anytime I was conversing with customers, he would literally butt into the middle of the conversation, giving an answer that I'd already told the customer. It was just so awkward, not only for me, but for the people that were coming into our store. I felt awful for them just having to witness this and kind of just go with it and watch me try to do anything, really, without him breathing down my neck. But that wasn't even the final straw for me. I'm usually great with just letting people get past their problems and I can continue working through just about anything. So I thought, okay, this will get better. He'll start to learn that I'm a good worker at my job. I sold more switches in a month than anybody else did. So this was really good for me. I was doing well. He was just always on my back. But then the job slowly started to decline. Before I knew it, I was being called in at all hours of the day when I was supposed to be off and working on my artwork. And they would just tell me that this girl, Julie, had not been able to show up or wasn't going to come in today. And she had only given them 30 minutes notice and I was supposed to come in at the drop of a hat. I had told them in my interview process that art was my main focus. This part-time job with GameStop had to come second, so I couldn't always come in whenever they needed me. it was really hard, and I did a few times, but most of the times I just wasn't able to. So one of these times, the next day when I came into work after they had called me, my manager took me into the back room and told me that I was going to have my pay docked because I couldn't come in whenever they needed me. This just felt so ridiculous to me. And on top of that, the pay reduction was 10 cents. Now that doesn't sound like much, but I wasn't even being paid minimum wage. I was being paid $9.40 when the minimum wage in my state is $10.40. So I was gonna be paid $9.30 an hour. That just sent my motivation down into a spiral. But it still didn't end there. The final straw was when John was working with me one night and I was on the computer talking on the phone with a customer. The customer was looking for a specific game and I was going through the database trying to find it for him. I went through all the games and before I knew it, I thought I had gone to the right menu and I hadn't. I was about to click back to go back to the original menu to find the correct one when John came over on my left side, reached all the way across my body, took the mouse out of my hand as he's leaning completely on me, and went to the menu that I was supposed to be at. This was just way past the line of being okay. I can understand, you know, being kind of frustrated with someone who might not be working as fast as you want them to, but to actually physically, basically push me away, take the mouse from my hand, and go to a menu that I was going to find in a few seconds anyway, was ridiculous. And I had really worked hard for this job. I had done everything they asked me to, and I loved working for these customers. But these working conditions just weren't okay, and the manager refused to do anything about it. She refused to do anything about my pay. She refused to do anything about other coworkers not being able to come in at the drop of a hat and then be me being forced to come in when I had another job that was basically more important to my life. So I gave my 2 weeks notice. That was it. I couldn't handle it anymore. And guess what? John is still working there, even after I filed a complaint and let the management know that he had been basically physically and mentally abusive in the workplace. So that was my time at GameStop. If you're ever thinking about working there, maybe it will go better for you, but yeah, it didn't go so great for me. That is the story of how I quit my job at GameStop. I hope you guys enjoyed this story time. Leave a like, leave a comment, tell me about workplace problems that you've had, or if you've actually loved your job, tell me the great stories you have to share in the comments below. And if you want to see more storytime videos like this, subscribe to my channel, and I hope to see you peeps again in the next video.